All right, guys, so today I'm going to talk to you about rain and why it's so important for your plants. And the reason I'm doing this video today is because I'm supposed to be in the garden doing some propagating videos for you, but I'm getting rained out. It was just pouring, but that's very, very good for the plants. And some of the plants in here that need a lot of rain are the ones that I have around me right now. Like, we'll start with this right here, the Alocasia poly, or the African mask. It's a really cool plant, super popular indoor and outdoor plant. I have them growing all over my gardens, on all sides of the house. They like a lot of shade, but they also like a lot of water. And when you have them in a pot, you want it to drain well. Like this one has a drain on it. When it fills up, I'll just pour it out. Here's another one, another Alocasia. All your Alocasias are gonna need a lot of water. They grow near the water. They like shade, filtered sun like you would get in a pool enclosure like this. Spider plants, another one that needs a whole lot of water. Indoors, a lot less water, but outside, natural to them to have a lot of water. They're getting the heat and the humidity that we have here in Florida. It's about 85% humidity right now, right between this little rain break we have. And that's what's really good for these plants. That's what makes these plants get these deep, thick, lush green leaves, is all that humidity and the water that's in the air. It's something you can't get in your house because the air conditioner sucks all the humidity out of the house. That's why no plants really do super well in the house, because it's not a natural setting. Even people that think plants are indoor plants, no, they're all outdoor plants. That's where they're naturally from. This big dumb cane here actually is an excellent indoor plant. Let me face this one at you. Of course, I have it growing outdoors here. This one's also poisonous, toxic. You get it in your mouth, they call it a dumb cane because you won't be able to talk. It actually makes it impossible for you to talk for about 15 minutes or so. That's what I hear. It's never happened to me. Great indoor plant, but also an excellent outdoor plant. And that's where we have this one growing, is outdoors here. And all these guys just love this rain that's coming down. These corn plants love it. They're a Dracaena. They're constantly drinking in this trunk right here and growing out new pieces. The coleus that are at the base, another one, we have to water these every day. If it doesn't rain, we're watering these coleus every single day because they drink a lot as well. We got a big variety of coleus here, some tea plants, another corn plant. The tea plant and the corn plant are both Dracaenas. Another dumb cane that I got from a cutting, and I'm gonna show you guys in another video how to make this plant. Whoop, got a lot of water in there. Get little cuttings like that and make them grow. Got several of these. And over here's the rattlesnake plant. Look how pretty these purple leaves are underneath. Big, pretty purple leaves. Really neat colors on the rattlesnake plant, one of my favorites. And it also likes a lot of water. It's a perfect thing to do when it's raining out, is just, you know, come and talk about the rain and all the plants that do so well in it. Money trees, another one. They're out here in this Florida weather. It rains pretty much every day in the summer here. And we don't move these plants around. We let them take it in and they love it. This plant, this is a money tree that was about this big and we got it, and it has taken off. It's only about a year and a half old in here. And you'll see more of these lady palms like this one here. Same deal. Now these don't take quite as much water, even though they grow naturally in our yard, and we have some over on the side yard over here. They do very good with all the rain, but when they're in a pot, they'll take a little bit less water because they can handle less. But you don't want them to dry out too much. When you've got a bunch of them popping out of a pot like this, you'll have to water the plant every day. At least you do when it's outdoors. And again, every one of these plants you see are gonna do great in the water. The big bird of paradise, the rain, that extra water on them, just always does good for them. And again, humidity is one of the best things for your plants that it just can't get indoors. If it starts raining outside, take your indoor plants out if you can. If you have a back porch or something, set them out in the rain and let them get that rainwater all over them, because it's excellent for them. It's full of things that your kitchen sink water is not full of. No chlorine, no chemicals, none of that junk. It's really good for your plants. I actually collect rainwater in buckets and in my coolers and stuff, because I give my plants rainwater when it's not raining. If I have a few days collected up, just go in, water the plants, it keeps them nice and healthy. See that? They're loving this rainwater all over them. Look at these new leaves coming out. That's why it's so nice to have a rainy day. Hope you enjoyed this video on rain. It was a lot of fun to do. Glad we got something done today. Supposed to rain heavier in the afternoon, and plants are gonna love it. I'll see you guys next time.